It wouldn't be a major election here in the state of Florida without last-second drama, razor-thin margins, and get ready for it, a recount. That is exactly what's happening in the Senate race here. Last night, despite the fact that Republican Governor Rick Scott declared victory, and so did the Republican Party here in the state of Florida, the margin is too thin. Senator Bill Nelson, who is trying for his fourth term, last night did not concede the race and said he would make a statement today. Well, today the new information came out that only about 34,000 votes separates the leader, Rick Scott, from Bill Nelson, who is trailing. That's out of 8.1 million votes overall in the state of Florida. And what that means is it falls within that half percentage point margin. And in Florida, law requires, if it falls in that margin, to do an automatic recount. So Senator Bill Nelson and his people say that they're going to send advisors and observers out to all of the different precincts to make sure that there are no irregularities or any mistakes, and to make sure that every single vote in the state of Florida is counted, because it will absolutely matter. Let's talk about the governor's race as well, a major victory for the Republicans and President Trump's agenda. President Trump's hand-picked candidate, Congressman Ron DeSantis, won this race also with a close margin, about 1%. In fact, it was so close that ABC News wasn't even projecting a winner last night when his opponent, the Democrat Tallahassee Mayor Andrew Gillum, stepped out onto the stage and conceded. And many of the people in the crowd were actually surprised to hear that. They were hoping that there was maybe still a shot, that maybe he would come out and declare victory or say, you know what, we're going to demand a recount. But instead, they were standing there and surprised by the Tallahassee mayor coming out saying that he called DeSantis, congratulated him, and was conceding the race. So once again, here we have in the state of Florida, if you go back, the last four major elections in this state, all decided by a margin of about 1%. That's exactly what happened here once again. But if these victories were to hold true, if the Republicans were to also be able to keep that Senate seat with the governor, Rick Scott, they would have two Republican senators serving at the same time for the first time in this state in more than 100 years. So a significant political foothold for the Republicans that they would maintain in a state that is so crucial and holds a lot of sway looking ahead to the next presidential election in 2020.
But to Texas, where Ted Cruz fought off a tough battle from Democrat Beto O'Rourke and held on to his Senate seat. Paula Ferris is in El Paso, and yes, O'Rourke lost, but we're hearing about the Beto effect still in effect. Paula.
Yeah, we sure are. Good morning to you, Robin. Texas Democrats, who are hoping for a victory, instead got hope for 2020. This race was a lot tighter than most people expected it to be. A record amount, $110 million, was poured into this state, into this particular race. In his concession speech last night, Congressman Beto O'Rourke said he's more hopeful than he's ever been about Texas and the country. He said he called Senator Cruz and told him that he would work with him anytime, anywhere, over the divisiveness in this country. But if you look at Beto's platform, he was out there on the stump campaigning for health care and unity and Dreamers. Rarely, if ever, was there a mention of the economy. You just wonder if that platform was a little too progressive for Texas. Cruz certainly thinks so. And Robin, Republicans here call him, quote, a shiny new penny.
Okay. 2020. I know we're just getting finished with 2018, but 2020, and you talked to Beto O'Rourke about the possibility of running for president.
Yes, I asked him if there was a scenario where he would run for president in 2020 or beyond. He said, quote, no, punto, period. For what it's worth, Cruz told me he would be surprised if Beto didn't run. And as for Cruz, who famously ran during his first term, I said, will you serve your full term? He said unequivocally he will serve his full term. So a lot to be determined down here in Texas, Robin.
A lot to be determined. And I've lost count how many people have said no and then end up in the process of running.
Ever.
Okay. Paula, thank you so much.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.